Hi, I'm Sasha Karlova, and today I'll be solving a problem involving electrostatics. We're given a simple diagram in which we know that there's a charge and the energy of minus 2q and another charge at minus 3, minus 5 of plus 6q. And the question is, where should we put a third charge such that the third charge will be still? Or in other words, that we will reach the equilibrium. So the first amongst this line, the first question we must ask ourselves is, where will that charge be? First, we'll take into consideration that the charge is here. Now, since this charge is much larger and is closer, we know that the force exerted by this charge will be much larger than the one exerted by this charge. So it's impossible to have an equilibrium in this region. At the same time, we know that it cannot be here, since if we had a charge here, if it were positive, this would push it this way, and this would pull it that same way. So it couldn't be in equilibrium, and if it were negative, it would be the same but in the other direction. So we know it has to be somewhere in this region. So to solve this problem, we'll be simplifying it a bit. We'll take into consideration that we have a single line, in which we have both charges, and we're looking where to put the charge at. We'll set the origin here, 0. And we know that this distance is this distance. And through Pythagoras' theorem, we know that that's the square root of 34. Square root of 34. So we want to know, where would we will be putting this charge? So we will write the Coulomb's equation for both particles. The first one will be, this is 6q, and this will be minus 2q. The first one will be k times 6q times q3. And here we'll have x plus the square root of 34 squared. And that will be equal to k times minus 2q times q3 divided by x squared. And as we can see, there's a lot of terms we can simply eliminate, such as k. This will sign will be inverted, since we want those both forces to be in opposite directions. So this is a plus 2. Now, we can eliminate k from both sides. We can eliminate q3 and q. So we get that 6 divided by this will equal this, 2 divided by this. We'll divide everything by 2. Just to save us some further work, we'll have 3, 1. And we'll do a cross multiplication here. And we'll get that 3x squared equals this squared, which will be x squared plus 2 times the square root of 34 plus 34. We'll take this x squared with one piece. And we can write our simple quadratic equation, being that we'll divide everything by 2 again. And we'll get x squared equals the square root of 34. There should be an x here. X plus 34. And we'll set these two to this side. And we'll get x squared minus square root of 34, x plus 34 equals 0. We'll input this into our calculators. Equation with of second degree, a will be 1, b will be minus the square root of 34, and c will be 34. We should be right. minus 30. And we get that x1 I'm sorry, I forgot to divide this by 2. It should be 17. So this should also be 17. So again, a is 1. B is the square root of 30, minus square root of 34. And c is minus 17. And then we have that the first x is x1 equals 7.97 and the x2 equals minus 2.13. Now we know that this is not possible since it put our charge here, and as we explained before, this will cause both forces to be on similar directions. So this is our answer. So we have that our point will be 7.97 units here. Understood? Now the next point is we have to get what coordinates are those. To do that, we'll take the unitary vector of this, which will be unitary vector equals 3/5 divided by the square root of 34. So our x component will be x1 will be 3 over the square root of 34 times 7.97, and we have that is 3 times 7.97 divided by the square root of 34, 4.1, and our y1 will be this was multiplied by 5, so we do 5 square root of 34 times 7.97. This equals 6.83. So our point will be 4.1 and 6.83. That's our solution. This is where we have to put our point in order to reach